almost a month after the first case of coronavirus was discovered in Nigeria, yet not a word from the Commander-in-Chief, Muhammadu Buhari. And private fuel marketers have some questions to ask before they begin to sell petrol at a new price of 125 naira per litre. This is Plus Politics, and I am Felicity Ezewuike. Thank you for joining us. Nigeria has now had a total of 12 cases of the coronavirus. However, no word from our president, Muhammadu Buhari. And reacting to the demands of Nigerians, asking the president to address the nation on this issue, the Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, said it is not yet the appropriate time for the president to do so. Joining us in the studio to have a conversation on this, political analyst, Alesta Wilcox, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you,
Felicity. Yes, indeed. Yeah, it's been a minute. Joining us via telephone is legal practitioner Taiwo Akinlami. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you for having me.
Pleasure to have you join us. The Senate has asked him. Nigerians are clamoring for his attention on social media. And they are watching as other world leaders take time, some quite frequently, to update the citizenry personally with their entourage of ministers and administrators backing up of consolidating on this information that is being said. Yet, the minister says when it is appropriate, Mr. Buhari will address the nation. Is this still a matter for consideration?
Well,
okay, let's start with Taiwo. Okay.
Hello?
Taiwo, go ahead.
Okay, I think that it calls for concern because globally, we've seen presidents, prime ministers come out to address their people, most importantly, to allay their fears, most importantly, to give them strength to go through this period. Most importantly, as the number one citizen of the of different countries, to let their people know what efforts they are making, and the impact of and how long this process is likely to take. But the case has been different in Nigeria. We've been listening to the Minister for Health. We've been listening to the Secretary to the Federal Government. But we have not heard from the president.
We just want to believe okay.
That the president is hale and healthy. And I think, again, we've seen him on TV when the governor of Lagos State went to Abuja to go and show him the pictures of Abule Ado. So I don't really understand why the president is not talking to us.
Okay, I want to jump in quickly and bring Mr. Lester in to talk about the other aspect of what the Minister of Information said. You actually alluded to it when you said we had ministers come up to give us an update, and we do know that the Ministry of Health has been in tip-top shape when it comes to information dissemination as regards this coronavirus. Lai Mohammed is saying that the things we want to hear from the president is already being disseminated, as it were. So there is really no need for the president to come in now, Alesta.
There is need for the president to speak, but it's not expedient. Sometimes we in Nigeria, we just want to create unnecessary gossip or something just to talk about. Understand? I think it, for me, it's scandalous for us to always want to create. I don't understand it. You see, who is the president? The president runs this country. He can delegate anybody to do anything on his behalf. Now, when this issue broke up, fortunately, it broke up in Lagos. The governor of Lagos State, in fact, took it up and was, as of today, even the commissioner of health in Lagos is briefing I'm coming. Let's not over dramatize some of these things. At the national level, the president has set up a high-powered committee. And when people say nobody has from the president, who set up the committee? A high-powered committee. Will hearing President Buhari say, fellow Nigerians, now does the whole, now eliminate the virus?
That's the sense of empathy.
There is no sense of anything. His empathy is the fact that he is on, like you just said, the Ministry of, look, I said first, it is good for our president to speak. But it's not an expedient thing. The officers directly reporting to him that are in charge are briefing Nigerians on a daily basis. We always want to make a political capital or political whatever out of everything. The next thing is become a political issue. Oh, President Biden didn't speak. We have all known this man ever since. He is a slow talker. He does not jump into the frame when the fire is hot.
Let me interject and ask you, before I come back to Mr. Taiwo, this is not an everyday occurrence.
Yes, I know that.
This is an unknown, relatively unknown kind of virus that is confronting not just Nigeria,
the
but globally.
Yes.
People are seeing on social media and on television the speed at which this virus is spreading and the global effort by other world leaders, and the efforts that they use to communicate to the people.
Yes.
What really does it take?
Which is happening.
Hold on, let me land. What really does it take for the president to take a minute and speak to the people directly as against using proxies at this urgent time?
My question now is, he's speaking to the, look, he should speak. That is okay. But he's not speaking. Has it increased the virus or diminished the virus? Has he going to speak now eliminate the virus from Nigeria that today we have 12 cases? Because he didn't speak, it is now 12. So when he speaks, it becomes 3. For me, it's an unnecessary distraction. The administration, as far as I'm concerned, the country is working. We should only either criticize if it's not enough or it is enough, we comment. We are having daily briefing. There's a situation room that has been set up by the president himself that is having daily coordinating activity and briefing. Money has been made available. Stimulus packages have been discussed. One of them is what we're going to discuss later. The CBN I'm sure with the president's approval, is making a provision of about 1 trillion for stimulus. These are measures.
Okay.
So the president coming to say, fellow Nigerians, I'm doing this and doing that, what is he going to add or subtract
from the current situation? Let's bring Taiwo in and just take a look at another angle. Slide a little and ask, some are saying there is a possibility that this move of the president not speaking is also a strategy to dampen what they describe as an increasing level of panic among Nigerians, especially with the number increasing today to 12. What do you say to that?
Well, Nigeria is a third world country. And we think, and there is a reason why we're a third world country. I hope you know that there's no nation God created and named a third world country. You are a third world country by reason of your social, economic, and political development. So there's a way things are done globally. So you expect that being a third world country, you expect this kind of reactions or this kind of actions from government. So government would rather spend state money to call a press conference, to issue press release, to dispatch the minister for information, to tell us why the president, who was elected for the welfare and the security of the people, why he's not talking to the people. Now, this is the point. Dispatching all of those things that have been dispatched, you are talking about the technical approach to this thing. There is a moral approach to it. There's a psychological approach to it. There's a joy a child feels when the child hears the voice of the father, because the father has come for the child. So there's a joy, there's a comfort, there's a moral stamina that the people get when the president, the prime minister, the head of government comes out to address the people. The people in the first world, in Germany, in the US, in France, in Italy, they are not crazy. They know the importance of this. Even in South Africa, there, Cyril Ramaphosa came out to address his people. So these are simple matters. When you understand the meaning of governor, nobody is interested in the voice of the president. But to the extent that you are the head of government, you are the commander-in-chief of the armed forces, the people, your voice alone, your assurance alone, to make a lot of difference. So if globally, there is a practice, Trump, President Trump, despite all the criticism, has come out almost every day in the midst of experts, people that have been on the field for years, briefing the nation on daily basis, because there's no other responsibility of state that is more important than the life and property of people. And so if the president is too busy, it may just mean that the president is yet to be persuaded about the impact of this coronavirus.
So you basically on the nation. Do not, you
and
basically...
So if that becomes the case, it means we cannot get the best of treatment in responding to this pandemic.
I'm just gonna take it that you do not see this as a strategy whatsoever, but
what strategy?
Are we
wiser than the first world countries? Chancellor Angela Merkel addressed the nation again yesterday. Are we wiser than all of those guys? They don't know what they are doing. They have better response, they have better equipment, they have better facilities, they have better experts, but the president is still coming out to address the nation. So how come our own president finds it difficult to address us? So if the situation is too demanding for him, if it's too big to address the country, why does he remain the president? Those are fundamental issues. So this is the problem I have.
Okay,
now
the gentleman
in the studio, can I conclude, please? The gentleman in the studio is saying we are making issues out of it. Now, how come the gentleman has a problem with those who are demanding for the president to speak, and he does not have a problem with a president who is acting out of order, completely out of order? Those are fundamental issues. So for me, it is about the moral authority of the president. It is about the fact that the president is the head of government. It is the fact that the president is the father of the nation. Mandela was called the father of South Africa. Lim Kuan Yew was called the father of Singapore. It is because the father of the nation appears to be sleeping and snoring in the midst of a moral crisis. That is the point.
All right, I need to interject.
It goes to the root of the responses that the government is deploying in all of these matters.
All right. I want to bring before we move on from the president's non-response to this. I want you to react to this. There are prominent Nigerians have come up, right? But I don't want to go picking all their comments. I'm going to focus on one who ran for the position of the presidency, and her name is Obi Ezekwesili. You're very familiar with her. Yes. She went on social media, Twitter, to put this out. And what she asked was, what kind of morbid silence is this from the leader of a country that is experiencing a ratcheting up of health crisis? A Nigerian gov puts the president in front of the cameras to speak to his citizens now. Leadership is not personal comfort. Will you say she is overreacting?
Look, these are all political nonsense.
Is this the time to be playing politics?
Of course, that's what people are doing.
You mean asking the president to speak?
And even my brother Taiwo is only trying to trying to whip up sentiment over an issue that has nothing to do with sentimentalism. Yeah, by the time he's referring to Angela Merkel or whoever or Trump, that has been their established culture. We had Ebola in this country. We had Ebola in this country in 2012.
Is Ebola of the same magnitude?
More magnitude. Ebola is 10 times. Mr. Taiwo, just listen. Ebola is 10 times more. Nobody's underrating Hold on, Mr. Taiwo.
It's your opinion. Nobody's undermining.
Nobody's undermining or underrating. Nobody's undermining or underrating the issues at hand. But by the time you come up with things like this, then you are trying to undermine and make petty out of it all. What are you expecting? A response of government. Of government. And government is responding in every ramification. And I've asked the question, does the he should speak. I'm not holding the administration to not speak.
Do you, let me.
Let me ask you a very,
he mentioned something that caught my attention. Yeah. He said this is beyond physical and, it's beyond physical. You have the psychological, emotional, and other aspects.
Yes.
And for the total well-being of people, yes, especially in this case, the citizenry, considering, yes, the situation in other places where there is panic in some, yes, places, don't you think, if, let's put a scenario that you are a father,
yes,
would you rather the doctor speaks to your child,
yes,
or you speak to your child? I'm trying to make it as, you well, know, as mundane the, as,
yes,
possible.
Yes, yes, I agree with you. Look, it's neither here nor there. Now, if the situation, that's why, like Mohammed has said, I'm not holding brief for government, I don't know where the government offices are. But like Mohammed has said, he will speak at the appropriate time.
All right,
now,
let's move on.
If the president, look, if the president, maybe he has his own strategy of speaking when maybe he felt this is the appropriate time. Where Taiwo is mentioning, that is their culture. If something can happen at 12
midnight, okay, I think you've said that before, so let's move on.
President Trump will wake up at 12 midnight to address the Americans. That is not what we do here.
Let's move on.
And so we must know our system. The government is on top of the situation, and we should...
Alesta, I'm the anchor of this program. Allow me to anchor, please. Thank you very much. All right, let's take a look at other issues arising. Today, 4 more cases was announced. I'm putting this question to you, Taiwo. Bringing the total number currently to 12, what further actions do you think the government should ramp up in the efforts to curtail the spread of this virus?
So if you listen to the plenary at the National Assembly, particularly the Senate, the resolutions that were passed yesterday, now this is an arm of government that is known to be an appendage of government, of the executive arm of government. But for the first time, seeing the danger ahead, you know, you see the National Assembly becoming more proactive, talking about testing centers, because you do not know whether there is corona, whether somebody is infected with corona or not, except the person is tested. The same crisis they face in America. Now, the question today is this: 36 states of the Federation, these geopolitical zones, where are the testing centers? How do people know? Where do people go? Apart from Lagos State, that is standing out in terms of providing information, direction, where are the other places that people can go? Now, I've listened to the briefing of the federal government. They keep the major thing they've spoken about is about the fact that there's reduction in pump price of fuel. Number two, that government functionaries will not travel. Number three, there's ban. These are things that are expected and should have been done well before now. But now they have been done. But now, what is the, beyond propaganda, beyond addressing press conference, they should give us numbers. They should give us centers that the Lagos State government has done of what we can call in Sampara, what we can call in Kano, what we can call in Maiduguri. These are fundamental issues. So as of today, when you are saying 12 that we know of, because many people have not been tested. The lady who came in on Friday from the UK, the 30-year-old lady, came in a full plane. Plane came in from the US. Where are those people? Have they been traced? Most of the effort have been done by the Lagos State government. So the fundamental thing, therefore, is that there are no visible efforts on ground to test people. So you cannot say you know the number of people that have been infected or not infected. And when people are infected, I hope you saw the video that went viral
of the guy that was quarantined in Ado-Ekiti, who went online to show the picture of where he was being kept. Your pig will not be kept in that place. So these are fundamental issues. What efforts are we making to test? When we test, whatever are we making to treat? Those are fundamental issues. What efforts are we making to protect our own people? Because it's now been said that people with preconditioned medical situation and people who are older have the tendency to be caught, to be infected. What effort are we making about our children? Our children are not being told to go home. When they go home, what precautionary measures are in place? So these are fundamental issues. So, for example, in Lagos State, government banned religious places from moving, from meeting. Now, Okeani Market is still there. My 12 Market is still there. There are more people converging in Okeani Market. There are more people converging in Balogun. There are more people converging in my 12 than converging in churches. So what are we doing about that?
All right, Taiwo, let's bring in Alesta to take another angle of this. You've raised quite a number of pertinent issues that needs to be reviewed. While we look forward to having some reactions to that, let's look at the concern that has been expressed by the World Health Organization's boss. He said Africa, not Nigeria, Africa should prepare for the worst, considering the fact that they have so far recorded 17 deaths in the last, as at yesterday, in 24 hours, 17 deaths in Africa. And then he said that we have a problem with data. We don't have the tech that some other parts of the world have. So my question is, how do you think we can mitigate the spread of this virus collectively as a continent? Because like it or not, this is not a time to say, I want to hoard information. Information is being shared across board.
No, but and that's why I'm surprised. I thank Mr. Taiwo on some of the issues he has raised, pertinent. But again, he seems to be lagging in the information that is available. I mean, the National Disease Control Center has been releasing information on a daily basis, phone numbers, toll-free numbers. I don't know if Mr. Taiwo is aware, or he's just being critical of the government and failed to be aware of what is happening. There are a lot of information going on. There is a designated toll-free lines that you can call from anywhere. So these things are all, we all measure the social media. This is all in social media.
Yeah, the question I actually asked you was, what can we do collectively as a continent, considering the fear?
A lot needs to be done. And I don't think the British should come and be increasing the fear. I heard somebody say 10 million deaths. There must be a joker. And I'm saying
there's no 10 million deaths. I heard somebody say it that somewhere.
It must be a joker to say, yes, we have weak institutions, weak healthcare systems, weak everything. But the same spirit within which we fought Ebola, which they didn't give us, they gave us support, but not publicity. And I'm sure this disease is not as deadly as Ebola. Yes, it might be a hidden disease, but it's not as deadly as Ebola. And I want to praise the government of Nigeria that fought Ebola, so we are also able and prepared to fight this. So all it takes for everybody not to drag. Yes, there is a lot that needs to be done. Like Mr. Taiwo said, restricting religious activity is the least of it all. If you have not closed schools, if you've not gone to Okeani Market or gone to Mile 12 Market to sensitize people, or to know what to do.
So now I come back to the same question that we're talking about before we came to this issue. Who should be making these announcements? Because as it is, only a few states like Anambra and some northwest states have come out to shut down schools and encourage people to moderate public gathering.
Yes.
But considering the unknown nature of this virus, he said, and you acknowledge, that you have to be tested in order for us to know that you are a carrier
of the virus.
Who should be in charge of making these announcements of no movement, stay at home, this is what I have done? Because as much as, yes, the Minister of Health can talk about the health aspect and how they are managing it, the Minister of Health cannot come unilaterally and say, shut down all schools in Nigeria.
No, but the state has the power to do that. You see, sometimes we think that, and that is where we have a problem in this country. We have three tiers of government, for goodness sake. Each of them have their budget and legislative competencies in their each area, in their various areas. I just read that in Enugu, they don't have an IDH center. Just like Lagos has. And you start blaming Buhari for that or the federal government for that. When a state has to have all this health infrastructure up and running,
this is our last.
Yes. What I'm saying in essence is, look, all hands must be on deck. The states, the local government, who should go to Okada market? Is it the Minister of Health from Abuja? There are Minister of Health in Lagos. Lagos is handling their case on a daily basis. It's disseminating information, billboards everywhere. So every other state should replicate that.
Let me bring in Taiwo. We don't have time. We don't have time.
More time. Yes. And there will be a coordination.
No, we don't have more time.
And then there'll be synergy.
I wanna ask you, Taiwo, quickly. I'm told we have less than 2 minutes to wrap up this segment of the program. Schools are being shut in certain states. Do you think it is time? And of course, you talked about a ban. It's actually a restriction on travel, not a ban or a shutdown of the airports or anything like that. With these new cases that we have, do you think it is time for a complete ban on travel as well as a shutdown of all schools across the Federation?
I think the gentleman in the studio, whom I would like to refer to as a dearly beloved brother, we are here to appreciate the impact of what is going on.
Bear in mind, we have limited time, sir.
Yes, we are here. So if we appreciate that, what we need to do is a total lockdown in places where this virus has been fought. For example, in China, they are recording tremendous progress. Just a total lockdown. So if you understand the fact that we're a third world country and we don't have the capacity, as it were, we will be more proactive. Because as a matter of fact, we needn't be at this point now if we have been proactive earlier, knowing that you don't have the capacity that the first world countries have, and we're behaving as if we have everything, and we were making out that we were ready, when in actual fact, in action, we were not ready.
All right.
May God help us.
Indeed, may God help us as we help ourselves. Thank you very much, Taiwo, for your time so far on the program.
Thank you so much for having me.
And of course, Alesta, thank you very much for your thoughts. All right, we'll go on a short break. And when we return, we're still talking developments on the coronavirus situation. We'll be looking at the reduction in petrol prices and how it is ruffling feathers. Do stay with us.